Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be doing another pick a card. Today we're going to be doing a pick a card all about who you're meant to be and your destiny. So this is going to give you a little bit of idea on your life purpose, who you came here on this earth to be, etc, etc. So let's get started with today's reading. So please choose your group now. We have group number one, group number two, group number three, and group number four. So let's get started with your reading. So if you'd like more time, please pause the video, and all the timestamps be down below in the comment section and in the description box down below. So let's get started with group number one. Hello group number one, thank you so much for being here. Let's get started with your reading. So let's see what the first card we have. So the first card we have is Void of Course Moon Missing. So for you guys, for your life purpose and your fate and why you're here, I do feel like you guys feel like you have always had something missing in your life. This isn't going to be forever. This could just be like a temporary thing. I am getting picking up a lot of Gemini energy from this group. So you could be a Gemini. You don't have to be though. So I feel like with this group, it's definitely picking up on something that you're missing. So it could be something to do with a hobby. It could be a talent. It could be a child. It could be all of those things. So I do feel like in terms of this lifetime, you are definitely going to be going through a really big transformation. And most likely, if you are feeling very confused in your life and you're like, I don't know where I'm going, I feel like I'm kind of missing out on something, then at some point in your life, you will finally find that thing, whether it be in your own emotional state, whether it be some sort of physical thing. But I do feel like it's something that's going to really impact you. It feels very intense and very kind of concrete. It feels like something that you have really been wanting your entire life. You may already have found it, but it does feel like for you guys it's something that's missing. It's kind of talking to me more about identity than anything else I'm feeling. So let's have a look at the other cards and let's see what we have here. Okay, I definitely feel like you guys are going to go through very big ancestral healing in your life at some point. It doesn't have to be in like a certain time frame, but it does feel like it's in certain points you're going to have a lot of ancestral healing. Your ancestors are holding space for you to heal your past. There's definitely energy of needing to let go as well, needing to let go of the past and kind of not hold on to things that are really not serving you. You guys do tend to hold on to things that aren't serving you, and sometimes you guys can, when you're in a toxic relationship and you don't always realize, it can come to the point where you stay in it for a little bit too long, but that's okay. A lot of us do it, you know, it's kind of normal, but there's definitely energy of surrendering. For you guys, okay, I'm sensing a lot of you guys go towards a project and then you stop, and then you stop yourself because you don't want to complete it, because possibly you're scared of the success, or you don't want to just have that accomplishment. And I feel like for a lot of you guys, you get to the line where you manifest something and then it kind of falls to pieces. So obviously I know this sounds really depressing, but it's not, it's just part of you is possibly scared of the success or scared of getting somewhere, because you may think that it's not going to turn out the way you wanted. You may get rejection, you know, all those things. So for you guys, this could also mean you're on a really pivotal transition point. You guys are really transitioning to a very deep place, and this could mean a lot to do with your emotional phase. I feel like there's definitely something cracking. There's something underneath the surface that's needing to come out. So for you guys, I feel like counseling or singing or dancing or anything where you can really express your emotions is going to be very, very helpful for you, because I feel like there's a part of you that really struggles to open up. And it could be that you don't actually want to do talking therapy. It could be something to do with like Reiki or something, just to cleanse your energy. I'm getting quite a lot of Virgo and Gemini energy from this, a bit of confusion. It's kind of like I've come to this earth and I'm very sensitive and I don't know what I'm doing with my energy. So for you guys, it's really important to protect yourself and also really work on finding your tribe, because I feel like for you guys, having a tribe to support you who have the same kind of, you know, road as you, who want to go in the same direction, it's going to be really good for you. It's kind of like, as long as you are with other people who are supporting you, it's going to really support your venture, because we can't do this on our own. And if we were meant to do it on our own, we wouldn't have all these other human beings here. So there's definitely energy of letting go of limiting beliefs around a certain thing and be as expansive in your thoughts as your soul is. Your soul is extremely expansive, and being around people who are equally as expansive is going to help you to expand this generally. Okay. So we have I have this really weird ankle pain that's so random. I'm getting a pain in my left ankle. So you guys may have had something to do in your past life to do with your left ankle, or you may have something on your left ankle. I'm not sure, but I'm getting a lot of pain there. So it's very, very random. So we have the waning gibbous and we have ambition. So this is all to do with your career. This is to do with the timing around your career. So in terms of your career, it could mean that it kind of comes into a waning gibbous when something really exciting happens. This is definitely to do with like nearly finishing a project or nearly getting somewhere and bailing out. And I don't mean this in a really awful way. I mean this in a sense that this is just something that's highlighted so you can possibly look at it and see if there's anything that you want to improve on. Especially with the impulsiveness as well, you guys, I know it sounds very depressing. I'm not trying to bash you. There's definitely a lot of things here that I want to say, okay? But we will get on to the more sparkly things, okay? But it's definitely more about you in terms of impulsiveness. There's a part of you that wants to get things done really, really quickly and just have them done and that's it, done, the end. Really kind of slow down. And I do feel like this is the missing part. The part of you that's missing could be the intimacy. It could be the intimacy with yourself and really looking at yourself. And a lot of the times we can become impulsive when we are missing something in our lives. And it's not always something we're very aware of. So you may not actually know what this is until it kind of comes around. But I do feel like this almost, where it says void of course moon, this void in a sense is kind of like can be filled with your own empathy and your own happiness and your own kind of blessings for yourself. As long as you know how to give this to yourself, that's going to be really great. And it's going to come in different forms. But I do feel like you guys are very ambitious. You're very career driven. I feel like your career is extremely important to you. And I feel like with this card, I always get it's your move. So whenever I get this card, obviously it's to do with career, but it feels like to me that it's kind of like the universe can only do so much here. And you've got to put in the effort, that last little 1% that you may be scared to do. But this, the fact that we have that last little 1% that you're possibly scared to do could be showing you that maybe that when you actually do it, then you're going to get so much more than what you thought you would. So maybe you're scared of that last 1% because you're very intuitive. You know that maybe on the other side is going to come with a lot of success. And sometimes we're scared of that and that's okay. Just as long as you know that it's going to kind of turn out okay and just go for it. Sometimes you just got to go over that kind of hump to kind of get to the other side, because behind the hump is scary. You know, it's kind of like, I don't know what's going to happen. We like to kind of know what's going to happen on the other side. So I feel like for you, it's really kind of coming back to yourself and recognizing what you really, really want and wanting it enough to just go towards it and go for it. You know, just keep going. Okay. So the animal cards you have here is the mouse, you have the nightingale and the elk. So various different types of personalities here. So obviously this is a general reading, so this is going to resonate with you guys differently. But I feel like for you guys are very, very sensitive. I also feel like you're some type of leader in some way. You guys really understand empathy. I feel like you are very sensitive. You guys feel empathy a lot and you can feel like you're upsetting people a lot. I don't know where that's coming from, my intuition, but I'm getting something like you feel like you're upsetting people all the time. You don't want to upset, you're scared of upsetting people. So you may hold your throat on your words back so you don't actually affect people. But your words are probably the strongest thing that you have. So actually the thing that you're holding back, as I say, is the thing that you're stopping yourself from doing, is the thing that's going to get you to where you need to be. So with the elk, I feel like there's some sort of mating call I'm hearing the elk makes. And I feel like for you, it's kind of like you're calling out to your life purpose, your drive, your absolute divinity. And I feel like all the time that you're using your voice, it's calling you back. And obviously everything that you are wanting is wanting you back anyway, you know, like your soulmate, your life purpose, your happiness, whatever makes you happy in this life is calling you in anyway. But it kind of feels like the more you use your voice, say if you do blogging, if you're on YouTube, if you do a podcast, singing, if you want to be an actor, an actress, all of those things are going to get you to where you need to go. You just have to place it in the right direction. So put yourself out there in terms of if you want to be an actress, like start some like acting in terms of like maybe doing some casting, like go on like a casting call, something like that. It's kind of like making the right moves to get into that slot. So if you're scared of doing something, it may be a call to actually do it and go for it, even though it's freaking scary, but like freaking going and doing it, that's gonna like push you towards this spot. And I feel like for you guys, you are very sensitive of other people's energy. So it's really important to come into your own energy and recognize when you're sucking up energy of other people. Because if you are doing this unintentionally, it can even be even more confusing because you're not actually doing it, you know, knowingly. And especially if you're an empath, you know, you're going to do it whether you know it or not. So yeah, that's what I'm feeling. So let's get you some chakra cards. We're going to see what sort of chakra you guys are working on the mainly in this lifetime. Oh, wow. Okay, we have two cards here. Okay, so we have the third chakra, solar plexus, self-confidence, and we have the first chakra, base, courage, and faith. That's what I'm feeling, and a lot of courage you guys need to kind of inhabit. I always get confused with those words, inhabit or inhibit. just kind of being in that energy is just going to help you to really know what you want. So we have self-confidence and courage and faith. So the main words I'm really focusing on is confidence and courage. Like, those two are really big for you guys. So it says, I trust myself fully. I will not allow fear or doubt to hold me back from what I'm doing. I trust myself fully. I will not allow fear or doubt to hold me back from doing what I'm here to do. I have confidence, belief, and conviction in my abilities and goals. I welcome questioning by others as this gives me a chance to clarify my truth, ideas, and philosophies. I trust in a higher power and I'm open to new challenges. So the other one is, I embrace courage, faith, and adaptability as they are needed for me to overcome my fear of change or the future. Exactly, you guys definitely have a fear of the future, and I feel like you guys are really working with that right now. So the more you're aware of this, I feel like the more it's going to come into fruition, okay? Not the fear, I mean the happiness on the other side of fear. And also the last chakra underneath is personal power. So this is extremely important. Wow, absolutely beautiful. So if you guys want to use those affirmations, I highly, highly recommend. I feel like they're really going to help you. So let's get you some tarot and let's see what's happening for you guys. Whoa, okay, that fell on the floor. Okay, so we have the Three of Cups. That's really beautiful. So Three of Cups is all about meeting your soul tribe. And that's what I'm feeling. That's what I felt with this crane card. We have the crane card here. It's all about meeting your soul tribe. It's all about kind of flying with people who really are on your wavelength, people who really suit you, people who are like you. And let's get a couple more. So you're definitely going to find them. I feel like you've been struggling for a while, and you possibly have been in toxic friendships, maybe in groups of three, where they've possibly ganged up on you and it's kind of been very intense. But I feel it's because you're very artistic and people can be very jealous of that, because you have all of these creative abilities that you, I feel like, are pushing back because you feel like you're not worthy of it. You're not worthy of possibly the success or actually expanding on your creative abilities. But I do feel like there's something about holding it in and holding it for yourself. For me as a Scorpio, that is like so preaching to the choir. But for me, what I learned on my journey is to really release things, as in really let people know how I'm feeling. And also to, in terms of like career and my creative abilities, is to share them. And before, I was very, very nervous to share them because I am very empathic myself. But I feel like the more I did express them, I felt more kind of powerful, because it's kind of like expressing that outwards, you know, and kind of getting it out and allowing people to look at it, because that can help people. You don't know what would help people. Maybe your art, maybe your singing, maybe your acting. It's all those different things. And we have the Four of Pentacles as well, so you may be holding on to it, but actually this can make you a lot of money as well. So if you want to have a creative career, this could definitely make you a lot of money, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna get you some dice and see what we have. Okay, so we have Neptune, we have Scorpio. That's interesting, because I was literally talking about myself. I'm Scorpio. Love that. We have the 12th house. So this is all about releasing, letting go. And Neptune here is all about the Piscean energy. It's all about the energy around that really deep emotional state, but also massive amount of emotional change. So I do feel like the Scorpionic energy, there is a part of you that really wants to hide itself out of feeling confused and scared to not make things too messy. There's definitely energy of moving away from this. And the 12th house is all about releasing. It's your karma, it's your past lives, it's your dreams, your subconscious. So the fact that we have Neptune, the fact that Neptune actually rules the 12th house, is showing me that we have so much water sign energy here. So there's definitely a really strong watery energy around this. So you may even be a water sign yourself, especially like Pisces or a Scorpio. But I do feel like there's a part of you that really needs to let go of doubt and just go for it. And I feel like this is definitely a strong message for those of you who really want to have a creative career or start a hobby, that you're possibly scared of what other people may think of you. And essentially, it's just all about you and how you feel and how you want to expand on this. So that's your reading, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for being here. If you'd like a private reading, all my information is down below, along with my crystal shop. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye. Hello, grit number two. Thank you so much for being here. Let's get started with your reading. Let's see what your destiny is, your fate, and what you need to learn in this lifetime. So let's start off with the top two cards we have here is Libra, Eye Balance, and Moon, Soul. So there's a lot to say about these two cards. So first of all, with this Libra energy, very much to do with relationships and how you balance yourself out. And the moon is all about how you feel. So put them together, essentially, you could have Libra moon, for starters. You could have Libra sun, or you could have Cancer moon, something like that. I do feel like there's an energy of your life purpose is to balance and bring balance to other people. So it could mean that you bring balance in terms of you could be a counselor, you could be helping people to gain emotional balance. It could mean that your essentially your soul's purpose is to help people have balance emotionally. I do feel like your life has been essentially quite unbalanced in terms of relationships recently or in the past, may not be anymore. Maybe this can be resolved, like this isn't set in stone, all the things that I'm saying. But I do feel like with the Libra Eye Balance, there's something to do with keep constantly finding balance within your body. So you could be very, very sensitive. You're somebody who takes on people's energies very, very strongly, especially those who you really, really care about. And I feel like it's really important to really focus on yourself when you get too overwhelmed. Because remember, you can't help other people if you can't help yourself. And especially if people are in crisis, the last thing that we need is another person in crisis, you know what I'm saying? I feel like for you guys, it's really important for you to balance yourself out, especially in your relationships. Like with the moon, it's definitely you take on all that energy of your partner or your friend or all of those things. So what's really important is just this balance. And the best thing about you is this Libra balance. You don't actually have to have Libra in your chart, but I do feel like for this energy, you may have it quite strongly, but also if you don't, it doesn't really matter. It's just kind of like the attributes that you take on. So what's really important is for you to constantly keep balancing yourself. Drink lots of water, take vitamins, take things that are really good for your body. And I feel like things that are artificial can really affect you. So things that are physically painful for you could be watching horror films. Things that are probably sometimes not as sensitive for other people can be very sensitive to you. So watching horror films, going on roller coasters, this can really like mess up your equilibrium. It can, and I'm doing this because it's kind of like the feminine and the masculine. I feel like both sides of you could get very, very confused. And I'm seeing like the feminine and the masculine and they're doing this. So they're not really like matching up and staying on the same length. They're kind of like doing this. So this may have been that you've had a sort of kind of hard relationship with your family as well. It could mean that you have had quite a hard relationship with one of your parents where you never were able to get balance with them. And this could have caused in your more adult teenhood, like later on in life, that you've really struggled to gain balance. And the best thing for you to do is to come back to yourself. That will really, really help you. So meditation is really, really good for you. And being out in nature is just going to be so, so, so helpful. And actually taking your time away from other people so you can be yourself and find out who you are. Because with Libras is they try to make themselves like the other person. And not consciously, this is never really a conscious thing, I don't feel. But it's more as in like, I want you to like me and I want to be with you. And it's never a bad thing. It's essentially, they just love so much, they care so much, and they want to love and they want to have balance. But sometimes that can actually cause imbalance because you're not being your most authentic self. So if you feel like you're taking on too much of other people's problems, sometimes it's best to just take your time away from those people just to give yourself that space. Because as I say, you can't benefit them if you're not benefiting yourself, okay? So the next card out we have is Kundalini Rising. Channel your creative passion, sensuality, welcome the transformation. So I do feel like for you guys, with your culture that possibly or where you grew up or how you grew up, I do feel like sensuality was very taboo or something that you couldn't really talk about. A lot of you guys are very passionate, I feel like, about sensuality, and you may have Libra, as I say, quite strongly in your chart, or Cancerian, where you really like the human body, anatomy and things like that, but other people could have thought that maybe like it's too much or, you know, it's too emotional or whatever. There's definitely a sense of creating compassion for yourself and that part of you that wants to express yourself. Really channeling your creative passions is going to really succeed and help you succeed and help you to become your most authentic self. It's going to actually really light a flame within you as well. There's definitely a part of you, your sacral chakra, that really wants to be lit up and really wants to be acknowledged, especially your inner child, a part of you that's just been lost. And it does feel like you have been kind of underneath the soil for a while and possibly reaching for help. I feel like for a lot of you guys, there's something to do with having counselling could really help you, even like talking to a friend, but I feel like more speaking out loud so you don't feel so alone and all the feelings that you're feeling are completely normal, okay? Sometimes when we don't express ourselves, we can think we're so alone and we're really confused, or we can just get really in our heads and think that this is it, you know? And it's not. You are not alone, and a lot of people feel this as well. And definitely, because you are so different from a lot of people, you may have felt very like an outcast. You may have felt like you don't fit in. And this is actually the best part of you. And this is actually the part of you that's going to pull you away, because you're not meant to be a part of the crowd. You're meant to help people come out into the 5D, come out into the lighter energy, away from that physical constriction, controlling energy, because that's, we're not meant to be in there. We're physical, squidgy human beings with emotions that need to be expressed. And if we're struggling to express them, you're going to help other people to express them, along with the fact that you may have gone through situations where you've needed to express yourself too. And it's going to really help you to kind of come out of that. So by helping yourself, you're helping other people too. Flattery, beautiful. So you could be somebody who is very, very beautiful. Obviously you're very beautiful anyway, without this card. But I do feel like a lot of people think you're very, very attractive. You could also be a twin or a triplet or even a quadruplet. Or you could have somebody who looks very much like you in your life. You may attract people who look like you. And a lot of the time this is normally quite accurate because we do kind of attract who we are. But I do feel like you may actually have a partner that looks a lot like you. And I feel like sometimes they may mistake you for like a brother or sister. And that does happen quite a lot, as I say, because we get attracted to people who look like us. So I do feel like you may kind of have somebody that looks very, very similar to you. You could have a best friend that looks very similar to you. I do feel like also, you may be a scientist or want to do something in the sciences where you kind of help people to discover what their DNA is, or you're very interested in history and kind of family kind of background and family trees and things like that. I do feel like you may meet somebody in the future who's very, very similar to you and really helps you on your journey, who really helps you to understand your authenticity and your authentic self. And we have the number three here, so this is very much to do with communication. So the more you communicate outwardly, it's to do work, hobbies, in your personal life, the more you're going to find yourself and therefore find your tribe and find people who really, really suit you and match up with your energy. And this is in Gemini as well, so you may be a little bit confused on how to really express this, but I feel like you will find this later on in life, okay? And it's all different for all of you guys. Okay, oh my God, we have Gemini. That's insane. I love this. Okay, so we have Gemini and then we have the second house of value. So actually, when you speak your truth, you can actually manifest quite a lot of abundance. Actually, a lot of abundance. They're saying like, it's the key to abundance is to really express yourself fully. Sorry guys, if I just hit the microphone. Fully express yourself, right? Really speak your truth. And even if you feel like you're like too harsh, too soft, any of these things, you are not any of those things. And if you think you're those things, then essentially, that may be the best part of you, because I have been told various different times of all the bad things that I have, you know, and that's only the reflection of what people think. And most of the time, if people say you're too emotional, you're too sensitive, they can't handle your sensitivity because they have emotional blockages. It's nothing to do with you, it's to do with how they are reacting to your energy. So I feel like the best thing for you to do is really invest in money with yourself. So say you have like a creative ability, you could easily make money off this. Very similar to the first message in group number one. I definitely feel like you're going to find your twin though, in a soulmate or a best friend or both. I feel like you're going to have this really nice warm tribe in your life. And if you haven't got it yet, I do feel like it's coming later on in life. I feel like you might be surrounded by a lot of animals as well in your life. It could be your dog walker, zoologist, something like that. You could just live with a lot of animals. You could be very into animals and things like that. I do feel like a lot of you guys have Cancer and really strongly in your chart. So we have the elephant, we have the panther, and we also have the snake. So lots of different attributes here. Is an energy of kind of pushing things out of the way but not forcing them. So essentially, if you feel like there's an emotional block within you, work with it. You may have a lot of anger in early on in life, or later on in life you haven't processed emotions. Be very aware as much as you can to step back from that anger. If you feel angry, express it, as long as you're not hurting anyone. But I do feel like it's really important for you to pull back and realize, what is this anger? Is it to do with feeling unsafe? Is it to do with feeling vulnerable? A lot of the time it's to do with feeling vulnerable, because we kind of lash out and want to be protected, you know? It's a sense of protection. It's kind of like when a lion roars at like an animal, it's kind of like to get it away from them or to scare it, you know? So the more you kind of express this emotion through your throat chakra, the more you're going to really take back your power that's a very big message actually. Like taking back your power is like a really big thing, so strongly. And this is a very random message, but I feel like some of you guys may have had a father who did fishing. So random, that's what I picked up on just then as I did this. So I do feel like camping could also be quite important to you. Being out in nature is really fun, and I feel like you need to do that more often. I feel like if you're kind of getting the urge to do that and you can, I'd say go do it. So the snake here is all about holding in your own intuition and intention, and this is very much to do with feeling safe. And we have the flower of life here. So for you guys, you could have been on this earth for a very, very long time. You could have done this before, you know, could have been a human before. But the funny thing is we don't remember. That's why we're here. So I do feel like this is something to do with romance. I feel like it's kind of to do with you have all this romantic energy and it's using it and acknowledging it that you have it. And it's not to feel embarrassed about it or, you know, feeling like you're not enough because you have it. It's actually expressing it and allowing people to find that within yourself. And I do feel like because this is with the earth energy, I feel like the more grounded you can become, essentially relaxing and really being centered in your energy, the more your thoughts are going to be able to line up and you'll be going to be able to think properly instead of it being like a muddle, especially if you have Gemini in your chart. That's going to really confuse you a lot of the time. So let's have a look at your chakras and let's see what chakra wants to come up for you guys. Let's see, give a bit of a shuffle here. Okay, let's see. Okay, so we have the third chakra, solar plexus, self-confidence, and we have the third eye chakra, acknowledgement of spirit. And then underneath we have the heart chakra, peace. I will meditate and be peaceful and calm in my interactions with others and the world. So if you want any of these affirmations, then have a look at those and see if you like any of those and possibly repeat them to yourself if you want to. So we also have, as I say, solar plexus and third eye. So the self-confidence says, I trust myself fully. I will not allow fear or doubt to hold me back from doing what I'm here to do. Okay, so have a look at that and see if you like any of those messages. And then third eye chakra, I trust in a higher source and I acknowledge my direct connection with it. So that could be another message for you guys. Hopefully you can see those. Okay, so those are your chakras. So definitely to do with your intuition and having actual confidence with your intuition. You may be a little bit unconfident with intuitive energy and kind of channeling, things like that. But I do feel like the more you can trust yourself, you're going to trust the universe more as well, and then not be so doubtful. So I do feel like for you guys, it's going to really serve you to look back at things and to observe and to try to think, is this the right situation for me? For you guys, because balance is so important, looking back at the things that you may have been holding on to is really, really important. To have kind of like a scan every now and then of your life to see if there's anything that you need to kind of not hold on to or let go of. And you may not be aware of this, so sometimes it can take a little bit of practice. But for those of you who feel like, oh no, I've kind of let everything go, and that's totally fine. If you've done that, then that's obviously what you've done, and that's a well done to you. But I feel like, especially with this Four of Pentacles, you guys hold on to money a lot as well for security. And actually sharing your money or spending it can actually be very beneficial for you, which sounds very strange for me to encourage you spending your money. But I feel like for you guys, you may hold it back because you feel like, oh, I don't have enough, or maybe you didn't have enough when you were a child. So actually, when you do get money, don't be afraid to spend it or actually to save it. It could be the opposite, to save it. And that could really help you to, you know, just be very expressive. And we're here to learn and to have fun. You know, it's not all about this serious kind of transformative energy all the time, you know, and it's coming from a Scorpio. So we had the High Priestess. You guys are very, very spiritual. You guys are definitely I'm hearing the hats of the universe. So it's kind of like you guys wear like a little hat, and it's kind of like a spiritual hat I'm hearing, and not everyone has this. I don't know why that's what they just told me. So it's kind of like you have the knowledge. Oh, you have the knowledge to kind of go towards something. And I feel like you guys are very like into philosophies and things. You like researching and looking into things quite deeply and into the minds. But I feel like you guys can get in your mind quite a lot because we have the Seven of Swords. Don't listen to people if they're being negative towards you and they're telling you that you're this and you're that. Don't listen to them. If it's not constructive criticism, let it be, let it ride. Okay, so we have the Sun in Pisces, the first house. You guys definitely are learning to be spiritual. The first house of the self is about your identity. It's also about your approach to life. So I feel like you guys, the more you enhance the spiritual ability of yours, whether it's clairvoyance, clairsentience, whether it's kind of meditating and doing your intuition that way, I just feel like it's about expressing your true nature and your lighter side of your energy. Because a lot of the time, especially if we are very, very sensitive, we can lash out, we can be very intense. I feel like it's really important for you to acknowledge the sensitive side of you and let that come out more. And that's going to really make your life so much more easier, I feel. Because I think it's kind of like what you need is on the other side of fear, essentially. And the only thing to fear is fear itself, which kind of always confused me. But after a while, I was like, that makes a lot of sense. So thank you so much for watching, guys. Also, the last message that I'm getting is to have boundaries. Boundaries are extremely important. And when we love ourselves enough to have boundaries, to say no to people or to leave relationships that aren't good for us, that's going to help us grow so much more. And it's going to enable you to have a much clearer, more abundant life for yourself. It's going to allow you more choice as well. And you're not restricting yourself. So doing a great job, guys. Well done you. So thank you so much for watching. If you'd like a private reading, all my information is down below. If you would like to check out my crystal shop, that's also down below. I hope you have a lovely day. And I'll speak to you soon. Much love. Bye. Hello, grid number 3. Thank you so much for being here. Let's get started with your reading. So let's start off with the first card. We have the Ninth House of Faith, number 33. So you guys could, number 33 could be a very strong number for you. I also feel like this is to do with communication as well, because the third house is to do with communication and things like that, messages and words and things like that. So this card actually comes out quite a lot, and it's definitely to do with kind of things really changing for you in terms of your spiritual journey. So the Ninth House is all about travel, it's about philosophies, it's about things that you can really research. It's things that are kind of in a faraway land to you. So things that you're going to discover. So I feel like for you guys, you are very, very witchy, very spiritual, and you're somebody who really likes to look into all the deep details of things. You love to kind of like look underneath things, look over it, look to the side, look to the other side, you know, like you like to really analyze things. And you could be a fixed sign, Leo, Aquarius, Taurus or Scorpio, somebody who just likes to really concentrate on something and analyze it. You could be really into tarot, you could be really into palm readings, and most likely you're into tarot because you're here watching this video. So let's have a look at the rest of the cards. So we have submission and we have intellect, the third house. There's definitely something to do with your intuition and kind of communicating with it through your voice. I definitely feel like for you guys, it's really important for you to express this through your voice. So the third house is all about your intellect. It's about you kind of creating this abundance. 3, 6, 9, 12. So it's funny, I'm getting kind of like a message around 3 and 12, and obviously there are 3s in 12. So I do feel like the more you build up this spiritual ability, it could be like channeling or really just researching things, I feel like this really sustains you and makes you feel really concrete and stable, because it's really good for you to find out all the different parts of things. And sometimes it can get too far where you kind of cause yourself to kind of be in this very, very tight gap, and it's really hard for you to get out of it. Sometimes you kind of trap yourself in a spot and you don't even realize that you're trapped. So I do feel like it's really important for you to realize there are choices and there are other ways of doing things. And it's not to obviously say that things you're looking at are not good, but it's also saying that when you do get in your head too much, it's to just step back, because sometimes it can get too much, especially if we're researching things that are especially in the 5D and very alien and very kind of intergalactic and things like that. It can get very confusing to your brain. So it's really being aware to step back from it sometimes and maybe watch some TV that's more earthy to kind of get you more grounded. Because obviously, if you're looking at things like that, our human brain can only comprehend so much. So just be very aware of that. But I do feel like you could have Mercury in Pisces, or you could have Pisces quite strongly in your chart. There is a part of you that does restrict yourself because you are so concentrated on something. You most likely won't start anything until you finished it. I feel like you're somebody who likes to go, burn yourself out. Be very careful with your health. You guys do like to go for it really hard. Okay, so it's really important for you to work on your health and work on your body, because your body is really important as well as your mind and your spiritual energy. So we have the Maiden and we have the Hedgehog. Acceptance, embrace who you are. So a lot of this energy around kind of looking deep into things could have made you somewhat of a an outcast in your life. It could have made you feel very different. And a lot of the times, those of you who do watch like spirituality videos, we have, a lot of us have felt like outcasts, you know, because being in the spiritual communities, we see things from a higher or the higher perspective. And a lot of the times is that can be feeling very separate, and that's okay. But at the end of the day, use those abilities for the best. Use it to channel, use it to help people and to guide them. And especially because you have so much knowledge, you can really share it with people who need it the most. And especially to embrace who you are, you guys are very, very sensitive, and you can be really, really hard on yourself because you think you're not good enough, you're not getting anywhere, you have to do this for a certain way. You could have your MC and your IC in Cancer and Capricorn or something, because I feel like you guys are very hard on yourself, but you're also very, very caring. So I do feel like it's really important for you to mother yourself. You may be a mother later on in life with the Maiden, but also you could just be a very mothering energy, and that can cause a lot of stress on you. And not to put so much pressure on yourself. And I do feel like there's a pressure to have children as well. And if there is a pressure to do that and you don't want children, then just acknowledge, this is my body. I get to do what I friggin' want with it. Especially if people are telling you to do this, do that. At the end of the day, we all have our own bodies and we can do whatever we want with them, because nobody can come at our body. No one can actually hurt us physically unless they obviously come at our external body. No one can actually get to the soul that's inside of our body. As long as we have the ability to really look into our minds and control our minds and really be, and not even control, just be very aware of our thoughts and our feelings, that is the control. You know, we can really lightly caress the mind to kind of be more calm, you know, and not to push it and force it and put it into a box that it's not meant to be in. Because a lot of the times, especially when we're younger, especially in education, as we get forced into a box that we're not meant to be in, because especially with the Capricorn age, it's like forcing and squishing us into a hole, into a box. And this is a very big rant. I'm not going to go on a rant with this because I will go off. But I do feel like the education system will definitely change. And I feel like by the time, for a lot of you guys who are around my age or younger, if you want to or are going to have children later on in life, I feel like the education system is going to be a lot different. So I feel like for you guys, it's going to be really important to express how you felt when you were in school for other people, for your children, for your grandchildren, to help them to embrace who they are as well, because it's very important, especially if you're very sensitive, is you can really doubt yourself because you care so damn much about people that you just want the best for everyone. And sometimes you can't do that. Sometimes it's not your responsibility. So deep stuff here today. So we have the Cheetah and the Dragon. So for you guys, you're very, very quick. You're quick thinkers. You guys are very, very spiritual. And you look into things very quickly and deeply. So you could be really good at trivia. You could be somebody like on a quiz night and all your mates are looking at you like, how the hell do you know all this stuff? And it could be that you're very intuitive as well. You intuitively just know things. And I feel like for you guys, you could be somebody who people come to when they want advice. You are the person who sees really deeply and past the illusions. And that can be really hard, especially if you don't know anyone else like that. It can be very lonely. And that's okay, guys. I'm like that. So if any of you guys are feeling lonely, know that you're not alone and other people are like it as well. So you also have the Cheetah as well. So you may want to rush past your spirituality to kind of get to the physical aspect. So you may think, for some of you guys, you may kind of push down your spirituality because you think it's not as important. It is very, very, very important. And you may want to rush things because you have maybe Mars in your birth chart very strongly. It could be an Aries or a Scorpio. But also it feels like you're kind of trying to rush things so you don't feel like you have the pressure on you. Okay, so it's learning to kind of hold that energy and hold that energy with yourself, and knowing that you can just really holding it in with yourself and really kind of building up your, almost your energy, building up your strength, building up your aura, so you can take on emotions that are quite hard, and then you can really process them instead of like crashing and kind of feeling really depressed and sad, which is obviously totally fine and totally normal to feel like that. I also feel like with the Cheetah as well, you're very ambitious. You're somebody who just wants things. And when you want them really badly. So not to say that you're somebody who like rushes things to kind of get it all the time. But when you're very passionate about something, you guys are super passionate about it. So it's really important for you to really go after what you're passionate about, because that's going to fuel you and give you abundance and give you confidence and knowing that you're not alone and you are going to really attract the things that you really want. Because especially if you are passionate about something, it means that it's worthwhile and it's worth exploring. Okay, oh my God, this is the third time this has come out for every single group. Personal power, third chakra, solar plexus. I choose to be myself and express my truth. I have a positive influence on people and the situations around me. I allow my integrity and confidence to shine, which instills more confidence and belief in myself and then encourages others to have natural confidence in me. I do not allow my personal power to become egotistical, manipulative, or exploitive. You guys have a lot of power. You could have a lot of fire in your chart. You're somebody who really, really takes on things very seriously and is kind of learning to step back from that. You're also very, very... I feel like you could work with children as well. Okay, definitely feel like your throat chakra and your third eye is very, very important. It's really important for you to express your truth, express your inner power. So if you guys want to check out these affirmations, feel free to pause the video. So throat chakra is connecting with spirit and third eye is knowledge. So this is definitely about maybe researching different archangels, researching different kind of deities I'm hearing. So it says, I feel like the main thing I'm really being connected to is these two quotes where it says, I ask my inner guidance to assist me in getting more in touch with my spirit. I know that if I ask for guidance, it will be given. So really asking for help as well, and knowing that when you do ask, you will receive. Maybe not always in the way you want it to, but you will receive, okay? You will receive the best of what you're meant to have. And then we also have, I use my intellect combined with my intuition to delve into circumstances from a philosophical and spiritual viewpoint. I also like, I cultivate positive beliefs about life, myself and others. Definitely. Positive beliefs about yourself is really, really important because it allows you to grow and expand. So yeah, we have the Ten of Cups and the Magician. Relationships are very important to you, and in this life you're most likely going to find your soulmate, somebody who really is your partner, somebody who is going to come through in a new beginning. So it's most likely going to be when you least expect it. I do feel like family is super, super important to you. It's a part of you that you really need. And I feel like it really helps you to realize your own personal power by being around people who are supportive and who really help you within that. So this is also, number one and two had this too, is to kind of not hold back on your spirituality and what you have to give. I do feel like you guys really don't want to express yourself sometimes, and that's okay. Sometimes you don't need to. But sometimes you really do, and it's just realizing where that is. And sometimes it can come from our inner child. We have the six of cups. So this is definitely to do with your inner child, and you may meet your past life soulmate very, very soon from watching this video as well. I do feel like you guys really connect with children, and you're also extremely spiritual. You're somebody who people go to for a lot of help, and I do feel like your mind can be your best friend or your most intense enemy. So obviously meditation is going to really, really help you with this. And also to not take things so seriously and not on your mind so seriously. So the dice we have here is the second house, Aquarius and Neptune. So it's really important for you to be independent with your money, but also to share it if you feel the need to. I feel like you're going to have a lot of control with your money over your lifetime. And I feel like you can easily have a lot of emotional attainment for your money. So spending it when you really want to, spending it on things you really, really want and treating yourself, but also being very independent and having that money away, saved in a bank account, away from, you know, spending it. So I kind of have balance in your career in terms of money as well. But I do feel like you're going to attain a lot of money through spirituality and sharing your philosophies and your ideas. So thank you so much for watching. If you'd like to check out my private readings and my crystal shop down below, please do. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye. Hello, good number four. Thank you so much for being here. Let's get started with your reading. So let's have a look and see what we got. So the first cards we have is Lunar Eclipse Change and Solar Eclipse Revolution. Ooh, I like that we have solar eclipse and lunar eclipse together. So very much to do with massive, massive changes. You guys have gone through or are going to go through a lot of different big, big, big transformations in your life. I feel like it's really connecting to your womb space is going to make you more powerful. And I feel like it's something to do with not being insecure about your stomach. Something to do with being insecure about your stomach. It could be to do with bloating, or possibly when you were pregnant, it could have really like made your body very, very confused and very kind of out of whack. So I do feel like for you guys, it's a lot of messages here. It's a lot to do with kind of like the femininity and energy, things like that. I do feel like for those of you who do have like periods and things, you may like sync up with the moon and things like that. So I do feel like you're going to go through a massive revolution and really big change in your life. You are the sort of person that installs change and creates change with other people. So when you come across people, you may have come across quite a few toxic people in your life. And for you, you may actually be the one to change and help them to change unknowingly. It doesn't have to be that you actually have to do anything. You just have to be yourself effectively. I do feel like you are very connected to the moon and you're somebody who really, really loves the moon. You're very, very caring, very, very empathetic, but you're also very driven and somebody who's really into career and somebody who's really just like a fireball. So I feel like you'll really learn to balance like your masculine and your feminine energy. So really learning to assert yourself, but also be very kind in your words. So for you guys, your soul tribe is going to be very, very important for you. I feel like you're going to find your soul friends and your soul mate. And I feel like it's really important to be seen to find your people. So you can't be seen by hiding behind other people or being like other people or aspiring to be like this person. It's kind of like, as long as you are, you know, getting inspired in the most blessed way, instead of kind of like being that person, that's going to really, really help you. So it's being seen and be authentically yourself. So just being yourself, like expressing yourself and doing things that are for you and not for anyone else. It's kind of like, I had a thought one day and it's kind of like, if everyone was gone from the planet and you were just you, would you be satisfied with your life? Would you be satisfied with who you are and what you do? Because a lot of the times is we unknowingly or unintentionally do things for other people and we don't even realize. We're kind of like, you know, buying this certain piece of clothing or whatever, you know, to make us look this certain way. And sometimes it can be like, you know, like kind of like fake Instagram posts where people are like posting their expensive cars and they're on a massive loan, you know. It's kind of like the most things that you can do is just be your most authentic self and be your unique self, be seen and be the chameleon. You don't have to blend in all the time, but if you feel the need to, then do that. But I do feel like it's really important for you to stand out, and as scary as that is, it's really, really important for your life purpose, I'm feeling. Okay, so the next cards we have is optimism, we have status and companionship. Love life is very, very important for you. I feel like you could even be in quite a prestigious partnership. You could be with somebody who's quite high up or quite famous. And I don't really like the word famous, more well-known. Somebody who's quite well-known, so you could be quite well-known. I don't see this as being, if you're like not really somebody who wants to be quite well-known, then I don't feel like you're going to be somebody who's that well-known. But I do feel like if you are wanting to be in like more of the public eye, I do feel like you're somebody who's going to be somebody who is quite well-off or somebody quite famous or somebody who's just very mature and who really wants to love you for who you are. I do feel like embracing your femininity and your natural beauty is really, really important, and to not kind of force yourself into a box and to say like, oh, I have to look like this because society wants me to. It's really important for you to just be your authentic self. And if you have big hips, work them. If you have small boobies, work them, you know. It's kind of like, just embrace your body and what it does, because at the end of the day, it's just a vessel to house our soul, you know. And obviously we can make it beautiful and we can make it what we want, of course we can. But if you feel the societal pressures to do that for yourself and it's not really from your own energy, then really try and pull back and work on what that emotion is before you possibly make a decision to do that. Because sometimes we do it for other people and that's okay, you know, it's not a bad thing. But at the end of the day, if you're not fulfilling your own happiness, then that could be something that could be blocking you from blessings. And obviously when I say blocking, it doesn't mean it's going to be there permanently. I just mean that it's something that you could maybe looking into or kind of step back from so you can really see what's going on. So with optimism, I feel like you're very optimistic. You're somebody who really helps people to see the best sides of life. You're somebody who's very happy and you're somebody who is like girl power, okay? Obviously, if you are a male, then probably male power, but it depends who you kind of associate with. So say if you are a female, more feminine power. I do feel like if you are a male as well, you are more for feminine power too. But I feel like with this card, especially, we have a lot of girls kind of like strutting their stuff. So I feel like you're somebody who's very feminine. As a female, I feel like you're very feminine. As a male, I feel like you're just very masculine. I feel like you are the gender that you kind of are, you know, as you associate with, whatever that is. And I do feel like you really embody that. And I think for a lot of you, you could have your moon in Sag or your moon in Libra as well, or your Jupiter in Taurus. And the companionship here is really, really important. To be around people who are supportive is very, very, very important to you. And I feel like your love life is like gonna blow up and be really great. And I feel like if you haven't found your soul tribe yet, just wait, it's gonna come. And I feel like it could be around a solar eclipse or a lunar eclipse that your love life changes, possibly because of the other astrological changes around it as well could really be supporting that. So, oh my God, we have lunar eclipse in another card. That is insane, I've never had that before. Wow, you guys are so connected to the moon. Damn, girl. So you have the lunar eclipse in this card. You have the lunar eclipse in this card, and you also have a full moon. So you are definitely a moon baby. You may have been born on a Cancer moon, someone who's very connected to the moon. Cancer moons are very connected to the moon. They just embody literally any sign that the moon is in. I know, being a Cancer moon, that I am, girl. But I feel like it's really, really important for you to just really expand yourself, express yourself. And the full moon is all about blessings, things coming back to you. So keep working at what you're doing. You're not going to miss out on things. You may feel like you are, but you're not going to miss out on things. Don't rush things. If you feel like you're going to like lose it all of a sudden, pull back from it. That's the best thing to do, especially if it's in like a relationship or something. You want somebody that's going to really fulfill you. So you may be a Capricorn, you may have Capricorn in your fourth house. If you do, that's all to do with career and working from home. So you could have a career where you work from home, or you want to be self-employed. It could also mean that you are somebody who is very career driven, and your work life is also connected to your home. So you may travel from one country to another and then come back home for quite a long time. You could be, say, connected to the army, or you could have a family member who's connected to the army. With the Capricorn as well, it's an energy of kind of strong, hard work, and also kind of forcing things. So make sure not to force things with family or your home. If you can't move, don't move. If you can't find a new house and you need to find one, possibly find a way of going around it instead of forcing it. Because I feel like for you guys, your home is very important to you. Feeling safe and fitting in your own little space is so important to you. And fourth house is Cancer, and it's actually ruled by the moon. So it's really important for you to have that safe space, especially if you are somebody who's very connected to your surroundings and your textures and your smells. Really important to surround yourself with good food, with lovely people, and just really nice lighting and really nice kind of candles and things like that. Lighting is very important, especially those who are very sensitive. If you can't get enough light into your room, like in my room, it's kind of can be quite hard to get lighting in here. Just get a light and like put it on, like my fairy lights. I put them on during the day because it makes my room look so pretty, but also it's mainly to just light up my room and make me feel very cozy and homely. You know, these little things can really help. Okay, so next thing is the castle. This is all about caging yourself in and feeling a lot. You guys are very much the feelers. I feel like you guys are somebody who really wants to extend your gifts to people. You love giving gifts, you love to share things. I'm seeing you like giving flowers. I'm feeling that flowers are very important to you. So having flowers in your room, in your world, is very important. You could be very interested in flowers. You could be somebody who wants to look at botanicals, or be something to do with like beauty, like putting like beauty products together. And my ear is ringing. You could be somebody who's is into like the kind of Latin kind of words to do with flowers and things like that. Something to do with like botanicals, I'm hearing. Just anything to do with botanicals and makeup, things like that. Later on, you could even create your own makeup line or your own kind of skincare line. I see that's for some of you guys, not everyone. So I feel like for you guys have gone through like 50 rebirths in your life. You could even only be 13 watching this, but I still feel like you could have gone through like 50 rebirths. So we have the golden egg and we have the scorpion. So very much a scorpionic energy, death and rebirth. So the golden egg is very much to do with the heart chakra. It's to do with feeling really, really safe and feeling like you can be in your own energy. Calling on your own inner power is going to be very, very good for you. So what makes you feel strong? What fulfills you? Is it that you need to kind of refuel if you're very introverted? Is it because you need to be in your own little space? Do you need to put some music on? Do you need to dance? Do you need to go for a run? Do you need to, you know, go out in nature? All these things. It's like little things can really, really help. But also I feel like for you guys, you've been burned very, very badly with relationships. You've been burnt by people, and it's really important, really, really important for you to have mature boundaries. So having mature boundaries with people, you know, having boundaries with yourself and saying no to people when you mean no. But also you may have had, you're very deep, I just feel like you're a very deep person. I feel like you are very, very intense as well. So when you feel something, you feel it, not just in your heart, you feel it in your whole entire existence. So I feel like it's really, really important that when you do come back to your safe space, talk to yourself, be really kind to yourself. Positive affirmations are really, really good. So if you can find some positive affirmations, that'll really, really help you. I do feel like for you guys, you can kind of sting a little bit if people hurt you. So it's really, really important for you to not kind of express that too harshly with people if you offend them too much. And obviously apologize if you do, but if you feel like you're kind of getting a bit too heated, step back as much as possible, because if it's not to not acknowledge what you're feeling, but not to put it onto somebody else. So you kind of like get it out. It's kind of getting it out in the best way that suits you. So how to get it out that's more kind of fluid and mature, you know, that sort of thing. But also, if you want to go have fun. It's a mix of like fun and seriousness. Sometimes you can take life too seriously as well. So go have more fun, I feel. So speaking of positive affirmations, we're going to pull some chakra cards. So there is some affirmations on here as well. This is the every single group has had the solar plexus. So I feel like all of you guys are working on confidence, I feel. Oh, you got two solar plexuses. Okay. Oh no, we have the solar plexus twice and the base chakra once, and we have the crown chakra of grace. So that is the crown chakra here. So if you want to pause the video, have a little look at that. And then we have the third chakra here of the solar plexus. This one says self-discipline. This says self-worth and self-esteem. My self-discipline and willpower will significantly help me in my efforts to move forward and grow. I am free of the need for the approval of others. I honor myself by doing things that please me, not only that please others. I am empowered as I release the need to live up to others' unrealistic expectations of me. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Those are gorgeous messages. I love these. So if you guys need to pause the video and have a little look at those, then please feel free to do so. And then we also have base chakra. Self-sufficiency. By finding material security without being materialistic, I gain satisfaction, stability, and inner strength. I am resourceful. I put in the effort to be responsible for supplying fundamental needs in my life, such as shelter, food, water, and clothing. I also got the message to not force yourself. Like, if you can and you don't have to force yourself to work, give yourself a day off and give yourself a break. Because with that Capricornian energy, it's that kind of forcing, having to do things, you know? So allowing yourself that you do have choice and you don't always have to do everything, okay? You don't have to do everything. You're not responsible for everything and everyone, although you might feel it, okay? So those are the other messages there. So if you want to pause the video, please feel free. If it wants to focus, focus, please focus on the card. Okay, it's not going to focus. Come on. Is it focus? There we go. Okay, so let's get you some tarot. Let's see what's going on with you guys. All right, so we have the Eight of Cups. It's really important for you to let go of any worry about yourself and knowing you're doing the best job that you can. You are worthy, you are enough, okay? And if there's anything that you need to let go of, it is important for you to observe it and to know that everything you let go of is for a reason, and the good things will come back to you, so you're not going to lose out on anything. Also, having a declutter every once in a while is going to really help you to clear your space. We also have the Seven of Swords. You guys can be a little bit suspicious sometimes, so being kind of like stepping back and realizing not everyone's going to let you down is very, very important, okay? Okay, oops, on the floor. So we do have a Knight of Wands here. So I do feel like it's really important for you to go towards your passions. That will lead you to fulfillment and possibly towards a fire sign who will have most likely a romantic interest in you, but also could be a friendship as well or a work-related partnership. You may also be surrounded by fire signs a lot of the time because you are very passionate. And also being surrounded by fire signs means that you need to bring up your self-confidence as well. But also it could be you need to be your own inner confidence. If you are a fire sign yourself and you lack confidence, it could be showing you that you need to work on your inner confidence within yourself and realizing that you don't have to rely on other people for that and you can find it within you. It's all about boundaries and just kind of reaching your potential, and sometimes it can be on the other side of fear. You know, it can be like, oh, I'm scared of leaving that relationship because, you know, what if I don't get anything else? What if I'm single for the rest of my life? You know, what's really important is it's my happiness and I'm going to take it and I'm going to use it. This is for myself, okay? So we also have the Two of Pentacles. This is about balance. This is about choosing yourself over everything else. That's what I just heard. So I also feel like it's about balancing your life to do with your career and your love life and your personal life. So what's really important is to not strain yourself, not to overdo it. And if you're feeling like things are too much, step back, 5-minute breather, come back to it. Because sometimes we can get too much into it. And especially if we do have an intense part of our personality, we can get very fixated on it. So distraction is very good, and meditation. Okay, so the Sun in Cancer in the 11th house. So for you guys, as I say, relationships are very important. The 11th house is all about the Aquarian energy. So it's ruled by Aquarius. It's very much to do, I'm pretty sure it's ruled by Aquarius. Forgive me if I'm wrong. I'm not sure. Pretty sure it is. So I feel like for you guys, it's really important for you to gain a strong perspective within yourself, to know that your knowledge is powerful, and to not judge others for their needs and their wants and things like that, and kind of stepping back from that. You could be a Cancerian sun or moon or rising as well, doesn't have to be. I feel like relationships and partnerships are very important to you. I feel like becoming connected with other people is so important, and you will find your tribe. I feel like a lot of your life is about finding your tribe and finding people who resonate with you, because people are very important to you. And the 11th house is all about community. It's all about finding your tribe, your community, your friendship. And I do feel like most likely you'll find a lot of happiness through tribal energy, but also not to blend in with that tribe and just to be your own unique self, because you have enough to give in that tribe, enough than not to blend in with everybody else. And yeah, just be really kind to yourself and know that you have a lot of love to give, and to give that to yourself, but also to share it with others. And to realize that sharing things and being vulnerable isn't a bad thing. It's actually a very brave thing, okay? So, and it's also not weak as well. For a lot of you guys have Capricorn, it may be a little bit of weakness. You may feel like it's weak to be kind of vulnerable and things, and that's okay. Working with that is really important, and to open up more with your speech is so important. So, last thing is also for like a circle. I'm seeing like a circle, and that could be quite important for some reason. It could be like the world or like yin yang, kind of like, things are going to start to come back around. So if things start to come back into your life, like old people or like old friendships, things like that, it's going to cause you to, it's going to help you to learn what it is you need to learn. So I feel like for you guys, it's really important for you to realize what this is showing you and not to go deep into it and really be sucked into it. Okay. So really acknowledge what is this showing me, and really realize that maybe there's possibly need to work on that old emotion that you're feeling with that old friendship or whatever, and kind of not being sucked into it. But I do feel like a lot of you guys are coming into a really big part of your life. So when you're watching this, I feel like you guys are really coming full circle, and there's a lot of new things coming towards you. So thank you so much for watching, guys. If you like this reading, don't forget to give it a big old thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you so much for being here. I love you guys so much. I appreciate you. You guys are amazing. I love the support and everything you do with my channel. I really, really appreciate it. Thank you so much. And if you'd like to get a private reading, or you want to check out my crystal shop, all the information is down below in the description box. Thank you so much for being here. Hope you have a lovely day. I'll speak to you soon. Bye.